perhaps the most well-known thing that Mexico has given to the world is...
Tequila!
Uno, dos, tres!
¡Salud!
If you've ever drank alcohol before, then you've probably tried tequila and you probably have some wild memories.
Oh my god.
No.
Here in Mexico, tequila is not just a drink. It's the actual name of a town, and as you can guess, it's where the drink is mass produced.
What is it like growing up in Tequila?
Well, it's a whole experience because here in Tequila is a small town, you know? And you have a lot of culture, you have a lot of activities, you have tradition, food. It's a wonderful place to visit.
Is it true that everybody who lives in Tequila likes tequila?
I love tequila.
Everybody, toda la gente aquí usa tequila.
Yeah. Siempre.
Literally, this entire town is tequila.
These are all tequila bars.
So this goes around the city. It's like a...
Even the ground is made from agave.
How many different kinds of tequila do you have here?
Probably like 25.
25? And they're all made here in tequila?
Yeah.
The reason that tequila is only made here is because Jalisco, the state that we're in, is the only place on earth that grows blue agave, the plant in which the drink is derived from.
Tequila!
The blue agave fields in this region are so magnificent that they are listed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site. The town of Tequila, which has around 50,000 residents, is colorful and lively, and it's loaded with distilleries and production plants.
So we are now walking in the city center?
Yes.
In the centro of Tequila.
Like the most beef cantina in the world.
Really?
Yes, you can drink in the street.
Everywhere, no problem.
Everywhere, no problem.
There are plenty of restaurants, bars, and tourist attractions around here, but at the end of the day, I know I came here for one reason, and that is to sample the local specialty. After all, it's the national drink of Mexico.
So this is where the tequila is made, in these giant containers. This is just so awesome. It's a small production, but that just means the best quality. We are now heading into the agave fields. How do you feel when you dress like that?
Más bonita.
You feel very beautiful?
Yeah.
Bueno, nos encontramos ahora en el corazón del paisaje agavero.
We're in the heart of the agave landscape.
Lo primero que pasa es una plantación inicia.
So when these baby agaves appear, they let them like around 2 or 3 years to grow. Then they take them and they plant in another field. And they let them mature around 7 to 10 years.
After adventuring across the endless agave fields and learning about how the plant becomes tequila, we finally sat down for an official tasting.
Vamos a olvidarnos del famoso shot, 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 shot.
We are gonna forget the come on shot with the lemon and the salt. We're gonna really try the tequila and know more about this drink. We're gonna remove this close to our nose and then we're gonna smell it, but slow because maybe it's gonna be a little bit strong.
Okay, vamos, ¿es así?
Uh-huh.
Ahora agitemos un poco la copa.
Now, we're gonna shake a little bit. So the first thing we're gonna do is take a little bit of tequila.
Ahora solamente vamos a preparar el paladar.
It's just to prepare your mouth.
I need lots of preparation.
Okay, vamos, pequeño sorbo.
A little bit. Mm.
Seguimos percibiendo las notas de sabor del tequila.
Can't feel my mouth.
¿Qué dices?
No siente.
Es normal que se sienta entumido.
Three shots of pure tequila straight from the source is more than enough to get your blood flowing. You can trust me on that one. To continue this wonderful day, my friends invited me to witness one of Mexico's greatest sports and traditions. You've heard of a cowboy before, right? Well, guess what? They originated here in Jalisco. Although the male cowboys are more famous around the world, their female counterparts called escaramuzas are just as special.
This is the national sport
for excellence in Mexico.
Their sport is called charrería, and it's basically a rodeo where they perform a series of tricks on their horses.
And what do you enjoy the most about it?
Stay with my horse. Toda la noche, cuando agarro la botella, yo te miro dentro de ella y me pongo a platicar.
Our final stop of the day was the biggest surprise yet, and it's certainly not for the faint-hearted. My friends wanted me to try this tequila-inspired beverage, so we headed to this rustic barn.
Well, we're gonna try a pajarete.
And what is that?
A drink with the goat milk.
It's literally milking the goat straight into a cup. Hola. ¿Cómo estás?
Leche.
¿Te gusta esa bebida?
Sí.
¿Mucho? ¿Todos los días?
Mira.
Sábado, domingo, lunes.
Salud.
Salud. Oh, muy bueno.
My Mexican friends have decided not to drink it, and I'm going to give it a try. So there's tequila, and there's wine, and sugar.
Cinnamon, coffee too.
So literally, they put like everything in a drink.
This is pure Mexican tradition.
I've seen a lot of things in this world and I've never seen anything remotely close
disgusting
to this drink. Oh, it's so warm. Salud. Tastes like chocolate milk. Seriously, I'm being completely honest. Well, that was a totally incredible experience that far blew away my expectations in tequila. What a place. I mean, I honestly, before I came to Mexico on this trip, I didn't even know this city existed, and now it's thriving and it's amazing, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Come get some tequila.
Arriba, abajo, al centro, para adentro.
Oh, it's in my mask. Now I got tequila mask.
3 times.
Respira primero.
No, you don't have to take the whole thing. You don't have to take the whole thing. Ready?
O sea, según yo leí un trago todo, aguante.
Just half of it. Are you ready?
No, no.
When you travel to different places and you tell people you're from Tequila, what do they say?
They say is there a city with that name? They don't believe that that drink has a name,
right?
In a city, so it's kind of funny.
Scared me. It scared the crap out of me.
I'm Drew Binsky, and if you like my travel videos, please click subscribe and join me as I plan to visit every country in the world.